You are a loser. You aren't good enough. You'll never be able to do anything. I can't tell you how many times I've heard these words, mostly by the people around me, but sometimes even from the voices in my own head. Yes, self-doubt hurts. Every time I feel self-doubt and low confidence, I remind myself of this story that I heard in school, and today I'm going to share it with you. Because if you too suffer from low confidence or a sense of self-doubt, you must watch this video right now. Once upon a time, many, many years ago, there were two kings. They were going to have a war. One of the kings decided he wanted to attack the other king. So he announced, every person in his country had to come and try out to enlist in the army. Every single person. They had auditions and the army was being chosen. Many, many people came to try out. Every single person came to try out. After a few days, they had finally selected all the people who would be in the army. The people that were selected were tall and strong and they looked burly and they looked like they were ready to fight because their task was difficult. They had to walk for many, many days and finally climb up a hill and attack the fort of the other king. All these men were tall and strong, the ones who had been chosen in the army. However, among them was a tiny little, thin little person called Timmy. Timmy was a very short and tiny little man, and upon knowing that he had also been selected for the army, he was surprised. In fact, he was also rather embarrassed. He thought that he didn't fit in among all these tall and strong people. Timmy, however, just because he had been ordered by the king, he also said that he would go on the long march and he would be a part of the group of people that was attacking that big fort on top of the hill. So the march started. The tall men walked like that every day, day after day after day, fully strong and burly and aggressive looking. And among them, tiny little Timmy struggled to catch up. He felt really small and unimportant, but he struggled to catch up. After a few days, some of the men noticed him. They realized how small and tiny he was. They said, "Why is he here in the army? He's too small. He won't be able to do anything at all." He became a laughingstock. Everybody around him realized that Timmy really couldn't have added much to an army at all. Timmy started feeling bad about himself. All the things that he heard from the people around him about how useless he was, about how he wasn't good for anything, he wasn't capable at all. He started telling himself the same stories. Those words became a part of the narrative that he told himself. And one night, Timmy felt all alone. He felt small. He felt absolutely dispensable. He felt worthless. He felt useless. And one day, in the middle of the night, when everyone else was asleep, Timmy ran away from the camp. No one noticed his absence. For the next 3 days, the big, burly soldiers of the army marched on and on and on until they could see in the distance that hill where the fortress was there that they were supposed to attack. They marched on bravely, screaming and shouting and knowing that they would give it their best and attack the fortress. They reached the fortress. Just when the army chief was about to say attack and all these men were going to attack, the king said, "Stop! Where's Timmy?" Everyone was shocked. Timmy? Why would the king need Timmy at a point like this? Timmy was tiny, Timmy was petite. Timmy had absolutely no role to play in the battleground, they felt. Everyone started looking around. They realized Timmy wasn't there. And the king told them, "Well then, let's march back, for we have already lost this battle before it started." You see, what had happened was that this fortress was absolutely strong. There was no way that they could attack the fortress with sheer force and might. The only way to enter the fortress was by digging a small hole underground and by sending a small person to crawl in through the hole, creep in unnoticed, and open the door of the fortress from inside. And the king had decided that Timmy would be the perfect person for this job, which is why he had been enlisted in the army in the first place. The battle was lost even before it had begun, and all the soldiers started regretting their decision for having made fun of Timmy, and they realized how important Timmy was for their whole team. So what exactly do we learn by this story? The first thing that I think I learned from this story was that nobody is unimportant. You might sometimes feel that I'm not important. What can I do? I'm too small to make a difference. I am absolutely worthless. I have no value in the world. People around you might be saying the same to you. But please remember, each one of us has a role to play. We may not be the best in studies, but we might be good in something else. You see, every single person is important. The engineer, the optimistic engineer who makes the airline, the pessimistic engineer who makes the parachute, the worker who puts the parachute in place, and also the adventure junkie who tries out the parachute for the first time. Every single person has a role to play. And while the role you play may not be the role that people expect of you, yet it doesn't mean that you're not important. So the first thing that we learn from this story is you are important. Every time you start doubting yourself, every time you start telling yourself you're not good enough, remember, there is something in which you're good and wonderful and unique, and you must always remember that and work towards that. The second thing that I learned from this story is this. Every single one of us is unique. And we spend so much of our lives trying to fit in with people who are not like us that we don't really remember our true greatness. I once read this, "Why try to fit in when you're born to stand out?" Isn't that true? Timmy wasn't like the others. He shouldn't have tried to fit in. He should have recognized his own uniqueness. He should have recognized his own beauty. Each one of us is like that. I didn't fit in with a lot of people for a lot of time. But does that mean I have no beauty inside me? Absolutely not. I started recognizing my own beauty. I started recognizing what I brought, the value I added to the world, and that really made me gain a lot of confidence. So, the second thing that we learn from this story is that each one of us is unique. Appreciate what makes you unique rather than trying to fit in with whatever you think society expects you to. Number three, extremely important. Small is a relative concept. You see, a building might be huge, but the entire Earth also is very small when you compare it to the rest of the solar system. What does this mean? Every time you think you're smaller than somebody else, please remember, it is still a relative concept. I know a lot of people who tell me, "I belong to a small country. My country is very small. My city is very small." Well, yes, it might be, but who are you comparing yourself to? It's extremely important to understand that small as a concept is really relative. It depends on what you're comparing yourself to. But my question is, if you are unique, if you are different, if you truly are one of a kind, why do you need to compare yourself to anybody else at all? Number four, the fourth thing that we learn from this story is also that small at times can be a huge advantage. You see, some countries, for example, Singapore, isn't the largest country in terms of land area or mass. However, its tiny size has proved invaluable because it could develop super fast. That's how they always say. A small country or a startup or a small organization is sometimes managed much more efficiently because decision making is faster. Everything can happen faster. Things can move faster. So sometimes small is an advantage. The fifth thing that I also learned from this story was that leaders need to understand their team members. I feel that in this story, the king was extremely good at understanding exactly what his team was like. He understood Timmy's strength. He understood that and he wanted to make the most of it. I think this is extremely important for anybody to be a good leader. Of course, the king did not convey it and the communication was missing in this case. However, he understood his team members really well. And the sixth and final thing that I learned from this story is never underestimate anyone at all. Yes, it's true. Sometimes we might feel that somebody else is of very little value. They are absolutely nothing compared to us. However, that's not true. Remember Blockbuster? That died completely because it underestimated Netflix and the plan of Netflix. Remember the Titanic? That got sunk because the Titanic had just one small hole, which was made by an iceberg. So if one hole can actually pull down and sink such a huge ship, if one small company like Netflix can completely dislodge Blockbuster, what hope do you and me have? On that note, I'd just like to tell you this. Every time you suffer from self-doubt, Ask yourself, what is it unique about you that you bring to the table? What value do you add that no one else in the world can add? And what exactly are your strengths and your magical powers and the gems inside of you? Take them out. Let the world see your brightness. Let the world see who you truly are. Don't try to fit in because you are born to stand out. And remember, you are enough. You are good enough. And you are meant to achieve great things.